Now that we've successfully built and tested our 5 1/4 inch woofer driver, we're now ready to install it into the ported enclosure to complete our product. The parts that we're going to be using in this assembly is a MDF enclosure. It's 3.16 cubic inch, that's about 3.5 liters. A plastic port, which will allow that box to be tuned to about 65 hertz. We'll need the lead set, which has connectors on one end to connect to the woofer, and a mini fit connector on the other end to connect to the customer's wire harness. And lastly, of course, we will have the driver and the Dacron polyfill that'll be used inside the box. Our first step is going to be installing the lead set into the box. We mate the ends that will be connecting to the speaker will be led in first. Next, we'll be adding the hot melt to cover up and seal the ingress hole from the lead set. We do that from the inside of the box for neatness on the outside and appearance. Our next step is to insert the Dacron into the enclosure. Next, we'll be installing the port. We apply a bead of adhesive around the flange of the port. The hole in the enclosure is undersized so that the port fits snugly into the hole, but the adhesive locks it in place. Next, we connect the wire harness to the woofer. We make sure that the polarity of the wires are correct. And now the woofer is ready to be screwed into the enclosure. And our subwoofer is completed and ready for final testing.
Another unique aspect of MISCO is that we're not only able to test the drivers that we make, the woofers, the tweeters, the mid-ranges, but we actually test the entire finished speaker enclosure for those that we build for customers.
After the speaker is assembled into the enclosure and the completed subwoofer is done, then we once again do an end-of-line test on the system. Now the driver has already been tested, and so we know that the parameters are met with the driver. But really this final test of the completed subwoofer is making sure, for example, that the wiring is correct, we haven't reversed the polarity, that there are no air leaks, there are no loose screws, anything that would cause the subwoofer to sound other than what the customer is expecting. This video series focused on a design of a very specific product. The steps that we took in building this speaker are very common to almost every type of speaker product that we do. Maybe it has an enclosure, maybe it doesn't. All of these steps are important to satisfy our customers' needs for the type of quality product they're expecting from MISCO.